Hello, I'm Alki Dez. I've won multiple Video of the Week awards, and today I'm going to teach you how to create a Growtopia animation. I'll show you what you need, the steps involved, and some key tips. After watching this video, you'll be able to make your own animations. This video consists of four parts: introduction to the softwares, creating character sprites, rigging the character, animating, and helpful tips for you. But first, I need to give you a warning. The animation software I'll be using in this video is a bit complex and requires experience. I'll provide the essential shortcuts and information, but I strongly recommend that you watch a Blender interface and shortcut tutorial before this video. That will make things much easier for you. Now let's get started. Here are the programs we'll need. For creating character sprites, AC Sprite or Photoshop. For rigging the character and animating, Blender. For editing the animation, CapCut, After Effects. All the necessary software we need is listed here. Now I will provide the essential shortcuts for Blender along with some additional information. This section is the menu where we create animations. This section is our timeline. This section displays the objects we have added to our scene. And this section is where we can adjust the settings of the objects. With these small icons, you can replace any menu with another one. These are the viewport settings. In render view, you can see lights and shadows. In the material menu, lights and shadows are not visible, but you can see textures. In solid view, only the shapes of the objects are visible. The next step is preparing the character sprites. For this, you first need a set. You can create and download a set from the Growtopia Set Planner website. After that, you need to separate all body parts into sections like this and name them accordingly. Open the set you downloaded in Sprite and follow my steps. First, scale down the sprite size by 25%. This way, it will be reduced to a 1-to-1 drawing size. Now press C to expand the canvas a bit. This way, you can add larger objects like hair and wings. Now press M to activate the selection tool, or you can also access it from the side menu. Cut the selected area with Control plus X, then create a new layer with Shift plus N. Paste it with Control plus V, and don't forget to name the layer. And we'll do this for all the other parts as well. You can install the Gatsby add-on to export your layers as PNG. Make sure all parts are saved this way. The next step is rigging our character. First, press Shift plus A, go to the Images menu, and click Mesh Plane. Select the images we prepared, but for the heads, only choose the one labeled number 1, then set the side panel options the same way I did. After that, it should look like this. While everything is selected, press R, then X, and then press 9 and 0 on the numpad. This will rotate it 90 degrees on the X-axis. Body parts are overlapping, so we need to fix that. We'll move the parts back and forth along the Y-axis to make the body look normal. Follow the same order I used. The head should be in the front, the left arm in the back, and so on. Adjust them exactly as you see on the screen. Now that it looks like a normal body, I'll quickly show you how to animate facial expressions. Change any menu you want to the shader menu, then replace the single image option with image sequence. Since we've already named the images 1 to 2, it will automatically recognize them. You can then animate the face by adjusting the offset number. Now press Shift plus A to add an armature, which means bone. Align the bone to the front, then switch to edit mode. Select the bone, press Shift plus D to duplicate it, and align it the same way I did. Now we'll connect the bones to each other. First, select the body bone, then select the bottom bone last. After pressing Ctrl plus P and choosing Keep Offset, the body bone will be controlled by the bottom bone. We will connect the arm, leg, and head bones to the body bone. As you can see, all the bones are now connected. Now we need to name these bones. Select a bone and press F2 to open the rename menu. Name all the bones according to the sprite they belong to. Our bones are ready, but the sprites are still not connected to the bones. Select all the sprites, then select the bones last. Press Ctrl plus P and choose Empty Groups. This will connect the sprites to the bones, but we still need to link each sprite to the correct bone individually. From the right menu, select the sprite you want, then switch to Edit Mode. Press A to select all the vertices, they should turn orange. Then go to the Vertex menu on the right, find the bone that matches the name of the selected sprite, and click Assign. This will connect the sprite to the bone. Now apply the same steps for all the other sprites. Now let's add a background, camera, and lighting. Import the two images you prepared, weather and dirt. Move the weather to the back and the dirt to the front. This way, our character will be positioned between them. Now let's add a camera and align it along the Y-axis. You can switch to camera view by pressing numpad 0. However, as you can see, the camera is currently in perspective mode. You need to switch it from perspective to orthographic to get a proper 2D view. With this setting, you can also adjust the zoom level. You need to move the camera forward along the Y-axis to ensure all sprites are visible. Now we have a scene. Let's add some lighting. To see the lighting, you need to switch to render view. You can add different types of lights from the Shift plus A menu. From the light settings menu on the right, you can change the color and intensity to create the lighting you want. The next step is animating. With the rig selected, switch to pose mode. Select the bottom location bone and position your character where it should be in the first frame. Go to any frame in the timeline that you want. Then, while your mouse cursor is in the viewport, press I to add a keyframe. If a yellow box appears, it means you have successfully added a pose to that frame. Now, in the timeline, select the next frame where you want your character to be, then move the location bone to the position you want. Press I again, and a new keyframe will be added. Now let's create a running animation. Follow what I did. Frame 10, running pose 1. Frame 15, running pose 2. Frame 18, running pose 3. Frame 22, copy paste, running pose 2, but be careful when copying poses, don't select the location bone. If you select it, you'll copy the position of the pose as well. So copy the poses without selecting the location bone. As you can see, this is how animation can be done. In Blender, you can add a keyframe for almost everything using the I key, like light color, facial expressions, camera size, and pretty much anything else. Making animated effects. To animate effects sprites, you'll need sequential effects sprites like this, and you'll have to save them as numbered PNG files. Next, import only the sprite labeled number 1 into Blender. Then open the shaders menu. And write the number of sprites in the frame section. Since there are 16 sprites, I will enter 16 there. Then click cyclic, and your animation will play nonstop. That's it. This is all I can show you. I look forward to seeing your amazing animations. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or reach out to me on Instagram. Goodbye and good luck.